So what is AWS? Well, AWS is a company, and AWS stands for Amazon Web Services. And as the name of that company already suggests, it is a subsidiary of Amazon, the Amazon that owns and operates Amazon.com, where you can buy books, fridges, and basically everything else. Now, AWS does not sell you fridges or books or anything like that. Instead, it is a cloud computing services provider. And that, of course, brings up one important other question. What exactly is cloud computing? Well, if we have a look at AWS' own definition, then cloud computing is the on-demand delivery of IT resources over the internet, with pay-as-you-go pricing, which essentially means that you only pay for the resources you are using and not for the IT resources you're not using. Now, this can still be a bit cryptic, but in the end, what cloud computing is all about and what it means is that there are cloud computing service provider companies like AWS or its competitors like Azure, which in the end own and operate IT resources, IT infrastructure in their own data centers, typically distributed across the entire world. For example, AWS does own and operate IT infrastructure across the entire globe, though I will get back to that later in that section. Now, the idea is that those companies own and operate that IT infrastructure. So in the end, data centers packed with computers, packed with servers, therefore. And as a customer, you can tap into that infrastructure. You can rent infrastructure from these cloud services providers, though as a customer of those providers, you typically don't rent individual computers or servers. You don't directly rent the IT infrastructure. Instead, you use services provided by those cloud computing service providers, hence the name, that are built on top of that IT infrastructure. For example, AWS offers a service that allows you as a customer to rent a slice of one of their servers, a virtual machine running on one of their servers. The idea being that the entire server is probably more powerful than you need it to be and would therefore be too expensive. Hence, AWS has that service where you can rent a slice of that machine, and they offer different slices with different hardware specifications so that different customers can get exactly that slice, that virtual server in the cloud that they need for their operations. That would be one example. Another example would be AWS Lambda, which allows you to just upload your code, which is then executed in the cloud. And as a customer, you don't need to worry about the underlying software or operating system at all. So instead of renting a real or virtual server, you just upload code, you define when it should be executed, and AWS takes care of all the rest. And these are just two examples. AWS has dozens of services that allow you to do all kinds of things, but that's therefore what cloud computing is all about. You, as a customer, can use the IT infrastructure that's owned and operated and managed by AWS. And those machines and data centers are in the cloud, you could say, because as a customer, you don't need to worry about the infrastructure at all. You don't need to know how big a data center is or where exactly it is. You don't need to replace failing IT infrastructure. Instead, for you as a customer, it's kind of like a black box to which you can send commands, for example, to start a new virtual server or to create a new managed database with another service provided by AWS about which you will learn later in the course. And therefore, you as a customer don't have to worry about the actual physical infrastructure. And indeed, AWS does all the heavy lifting. When you as a customer send a command like start a new server, and you can send those commands in different ways, for example, through a graphical web user interface, then AWS will pick a fitting physical machine to give you that virtual server which you want to start, And you as a customer don't have to worry about any of the things that are happening under the hood. And as a customer, IT resources are there for just one command or one click if you're using the graphical user interface away, and you can get started instantly and use cloud resources just as you need them. So that's what AWS is and what cloud computing is. It's about the on-demand usage and delivery of IT resources, for example, to rent a server on which you want to serve a website, or to rent some file storage volumes, for which AWS also has services, as you will learn. And as a customer, you have a great degree of flexibility because you can use compute power and data storage just as you need it. You can get rid of IT resources you don't need anymore anytime. You don't need to provision or maintain your own data centers. You don't need to own and operate your own physical infrastructure. And when using the cloud and cloud computing and service providers like AWS, then as a customer, you only pay for the IT resources you are using when you're using them. And when you stop using a certain AWS service, you're not paying for it anymore.